Let us begin our today's class with divisibility test. Already you have studied about divisibility test, isn't it? Last class also. Last year also you have studied divisibility test and divisibility rules, isn't it? Any doubt? No. So let us move to the methods that we needed divisibility test. So, divisibility tests are commonly used for the numbers. Divisibility rules or divisibility tests are used only for divisibility test by 2, by 3, by 4, by 5, by 6, by 7, by 8, by 9, by 10 and by 11. Actually, this test will help us whether it is completely divisible or not. Without dividing or before dividing the number, we can predict. Okay, whether the given number is divisible by 2, divisible by 3, divisible by 10, divisible by 11, etc. using these rules. Okay, and teacher is not following the textbook order. We can group them. Okay, first the teacher is grouping the divisibility test of 2, 5 and 10 together. Because 2, 5 and 10 are very easy. By seeing the ones digit or ending digit itself, we can predict whether they are divisible by 2 or divisible by 5 or divisible by 10. So let us move to our divisibility rules. What are the rules? First let us go through divisibility by 2. It's very easy for you. By seeing the number itself, we can predict or we can say whether it is divisible by 2 or not. How to do? If a number ends with, if the given number ends with 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. We can say that the given number is completely divisible by 2. You just want to look at the ones digit only. If the one digit is 0 or it is 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, directly we can write the given number, whatever it may be, whether it is small number or whether it is big number, we needn't want to do actual division. Directly we can write, it is completely divisible by 2. Okay, let us move to divisibility by 5. How to say that whether the given number, suppose maybe a large number given to you, how to say whether it is completely divisible by 5 without dividing, without actual division? How can we say? Look at the ending digit. If the digit given number ends with 0 or 5, ends with 0 or 5, we can say that the given number is completely divisible by 5. Number ends with two cases, either 0 or 5. Without dividing, we can say that given number is divisible by 5. Okay, let us move to the third one. Let us move to our third problem. Third one is what? Divisibility by 10. Very clear. If a number ends with 0, surely the given number is divisible by 10. Means whatever be the number which ends in 0 is completely divisible by 10. So, first teacher has taken 2. Number ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 anangil, completely divisible by 2. If a number ends with 0 or 5, divisible by 5. If a number ends in 10 anangil, or ends in 0 anangil, completely divisible by 10. But 2, 5, 10, got it now. Next teacher is grouping another, that is 3 and 9. Let us see the case of 3, divisibility by 3. How to check whether given a number by divisible by 3 or not? Previous cases, last digit enough to us. But in case of 3, is it possible? No, it is not possible always. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to find the sum of digits of the number. Sum of digits of the number. So, let us see for example, 168. Given number is 168. What is the sum of its digit? 1 plus 6 plus 8. 1 plus 6 plus 8 is how much for us? 15. 1 plus 6 plus 8 is 15. Now you think about 15 is small number now. 15 is divisible by 3. Yes, 15 is completely divisible. So what can we write? The given 168 is also divisible by 3. So the divisibility by 3, the rule says that sum of digits is divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. Okay, let us move to our next one, that is divisibility by 9. Divisibility by 9 is same as divisibility by 3. What is it? Sum of digits of a given number is divisible by 9. Then the whole number is divisible by 9. Okay. Sum of digits of 9 is sum of digits of given number is divisible by 9. The whole number is divisible. For example, teacher has taken a number 15,138. What is the sum of its digits? Sum of digits is 18. And it is very clear, 18 is divisible by 9, isn't it? So, what can we say? The big number 15,138 is also divisible by what? By 9. Is it clear up to this? Let us move to the other property. Next, let us move to divisibility by 4. Okay, first we started with ending digits. In case of which one? 2, 5 and 10. Then in case of 3 and 9, what we have applied? Same rule applied. Which one? Sum of digits divisible by 3, whole number divisible. Sum of digit divisible by 9, whole digit divisible by 9. Next, we are grouping 4 and 8 together. 4 and 8 together. Little bit same, something different. Let us see divisibility by 4. We can't see go through with the ending digits possible. Sum of digits possible. Then what we do? Here they say that look at the last two digits. Last two digit means 1's digit and 10's digit together. Okay, 1's digit and 10's digit together as a number. That's why they told you the last two digits of the number. Okay, last two digits of the given number is divisible by 4. Then what can we say? The whole number is divisible by 4. The whole number is divisible by 4. Okay, so for example, 3428 is the given number. Last two digit means here the number is 28. And already we know 28 is divisible by 4. Which means what? 34 is also, 28 is divisible by 4. It's very clear. Which implies the given number 3428 is also divisible by 4. Divisible by 4. Is it clear to all? Okay. Let us move to the next divisibility rule by 8. Let us move to our divisibility by 8. Divisibility by 8, already teacher told you little bit same as divisibility by 4. Isn't it? So in divisibility by 8, in divisibility by 4, we have to consider the last two digits of the given number. And if it is divisible by 4, the whole number is divisible by 4, we have studied. Isn't it? Here it is little bit same. If the last three digits of the number is divisible by 8, then the whole number is also divisible by 8. For example, look at the example is given in our textbook also. 48,12,848. Without dividing, can you predict? No, it is not easy, isn't it? So what we have to do? Look at the last three digits. And last three digit means directly same as previous cases we can't say. So let us divide by 8. Take the last three digits as 848. Let us begin our division. So in 8, one time only. Then bring down 4. In 4, is it possible? No. So what we have to do? Write 0 on the top, bring down 8. In 48, 6 times. And our remainder is 0. So divisible alle. So we can write 848 divisible by 8. Divisible by 8. Because we got the answer now, which implies the given bit number 48,12,848 is also divisible by 8. Is also divisible by 8. Is it clear? Let us move to the other divisibility rules. Divisibility by 6 are. Next rule is, next remaining numbers are 6, 7, 11 are. Entirely different cases are. Okay. Up to this time we started with 2, 5, 10 or A group. 3 and 9 next group. 4 and 8 together. But these remaining are all different conditions. First one, divisibility by 6, little bit easy. Why? Because the condition says that if the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, both conditions is to be satisfied. Given number must be divisible by 2 and also it must be divisible by 3. If both the condition is true, then only we can say that the given number is divisible by 6. For example, teacher has taken a number 12,936. In case of 2, what we have to do? The given number ends in 6. Number ends in 6 implies it is divisible by 2. Without any doubt, we can directly write divisible by 2. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. It is divisible by 2. We have studied. Now let us go through with the condition divisible by 3 or no. For that, we need sum of digits. In case of 3 and in case of 9, sum of digits. Add all these. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 9, 12. 12 plus 3, 15. 15 plus 6, 21. Is 21 divisible by 3? Yes. 21, comma, divisible by 3. Divisible by 3. What does it imply? 12,936 is divisible by 3. The number is divisible by 3. See, two conditions satisfied. Divisible by 2, divisible by 3. Therefore, 12,936 is divisible by 6. Divisible by 6. Divisible by 6. Is it clear? Let us move to the case of divisibility by 7. And it is little bit different. It's already told you. Anyway, look at. If the difference between, here we have to find a difference between twice the last digit. Whatever be the last digit, you have to double it or twice. So, twice the last digit and the remaining number. And the remaining number, we can have. So, difference between twice the last digit and the number formed by remaining digits. Okay. The number with remaining digits is 0 or divisible by 7. The whole number is divisible by 7. What they told you is, look at the first digit, that is last digit. Double it. So, double of last digit. Double of last digit. What is double of last digit? It is 6. What is the number formed by remaining digits? Number formed by remaining digits. Remaining digits. What is the number formed by remaining digits? 496. Then you find the difference between these two. Find the difference between these two. Either first you have to find the ending digit. Double it. So we have 6. Then you have to consider the number formed by remaining digits. Last digit we have taken out. So remaining digits are 496 together. 496 is the number. Then you find the difference between these two. So we have 496 minus 6. What we have? 490 is surely divisible by 7. So we can write is divisible by 7. Therefore, 4963 is also divisible by 7. Good idea. Divisibility rule of 7 says that you have to find the double of last digit and the number formed by remaining digits has to be subtracted. Okay, you have to subtract this twice of last digit from the number formed by remaining digits. If the difference is divisible by 7, the whole number is also divisible by 7. Okay, complete till this. Thank you.